Sorry, Cabal Vision thingy. So we've actually got the World Cup thing started. No, not started, but it's there. So I talked to Nethios, who runs the communications for Cyanide, and he actually told me that they're going to be limiting the concessions to to 5 across the entire season of the World Cup entries, which is great. Yes, exactly, Monkey G. So if people really, really know what they're doing, then they won't be getting surfed that much, which means the Witch Elf is less valuable, and I would probably still go with 4 Blitzers, 1 Runner, 2 Rerolls. But because surfing is so great here, I think on Cyanide, 1 Witch and 3 Blitzers is better. Darkies it is. Let me just move the chat there. Very funny, snipe. Let's all snipe concede. Please don't. I would really, yeah. I mean, it happened once, and it has done wonders for that team, of course, because 25-0-1 is not nearly as expressive. Ooh, speak. Not nearly as impressive as 26-0-0 is. Right, that is a problem, Squiggy. Let's see. So, who am I playing? Blood Prince. Right. So the number of coaches looking for. Let me do my setup here. So the number of coaches is not that informative because there's. There's a lot of people looking for games at different team values. He has a witch, so let's not get surfed here. I think I'll just go for a rule of 5, actually. Make him pick a sideline, basically. Let's save the setup. Right. So it's a bit further back because Dark Elves are fast enough to blitz these guys. So finding a match on Fumble definitely takes a bit more effort and time than it does on Cyanide, which is one of the other main appealing factors. So before I said the thing that makes Blood Bowl 2 better than Fumble is graphics. That is still the main thing. Sorry, but the ease of finding a game is definitely another. Well, since there is not much pressure on right now, cheers, guys. This was actually a Christmas present, and it's a very nice Islay. Hey there, Pudney. Long time no see. Welcome back, man. Right, Blitz here would be nice. Thank you, Seed. Yes. Always nice to be confronted with your own sort of wise-ish words. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah, I don't usually watch the list of viewers at all. So if you're not on the chat, I don't know that you're here, basically. Right, so you went with four blitzers and a witch, but that leaves you with only one reroll. That's right. Now, if rerolls weren't... What's with the cam? That was terrible. If rerolls weren't double price after team creation, I would... Thank you. Yeah, I would appreciate that. It's always nice to know who's there. So if rerolls weren't double priced after team creation, I might be tempted to go with four blitzers as well. Okay, say hi. Hello. Yes, good. And that's the reroll thing. Well, at least it worked. Damn. Trinity is stunned. Indeed, and it's gone. Also, if you're gonna go with four blitzers, you might want to block with them on the line of scrimmage, because you got four blocks, that's three LOS blocks, plus a blitz. At least that's what I'd use them for. No chat. That is a good whiskey. Really, Squiggy? Well, I mean, they only have one more movement than the linemen, and really, using block is what they're for. And the movement is like an extra, in my opinion. Okay. Yes, it is an Islay single malt. It's 12 years. Here it is. Can you see this? Kind of. Yep, that's the one. So, a good position to score from, but not an ideal position to proceed from, basically. Yeah, it does sound quite possible, Shani. Graag gedaan, stickers. Right, so movement and agility. Well, dodge is definitely the first thing you want. I wouldn't get jump up. I think leap is good, of course, with agility 5. But blodge sidestep is... I wouldn't get jump up at all on that guy. But blodge sidestep would be a very solid way to go. So I think I've got enough guys to actually get a double layer back here. So two guys here and then one there to prevent getting surfed. Yes, I like that. Pro is not bad, because it lets you use it on leaps, but it wouldn't be my recommendation, no. So I think blodge, sure hands, sidestep is how I would build that guy. But there's lots of options there. Right, so I'm not gonna blitz with the witch because I'm not surfing here. Chain pushing him, put him in there, would still not get a surf. So it's... This guy is someone I would like to move, at least. So the thing is, what you would use him for is to pick up the balls that would otherwise be very hard to get at. Right, so I want him to be boxed in here. This will do that sufficiently, I'd say. 4, 5, 6 would leave him there. So let's put this guy here. Yes, this looks good. Strip ball is certainly also a very, very. Agility 5, movement 8, strip ball is definitely also an amazing player. Yes. I mean, it's better on a wrestler, but you can't have everything, right? This would leave something of a hole here. I'm gonna go there. Oh, I'm not going to go there. Yeah, if you say I give him dodge, strip ball, leap, I couldn't fault you for that either. Agreed. But jump up is really not worth it on a player like that. Right, so he'll probably want to switch sides here, because he's not getting through here with any reliable odds. I wanted to make it less easy for him to switch sides with this guy, but that didn't happen. Also, these stuns didn't help. But he's got enough of his team really funneled down the side that switching sides will be tough. Also, judging from what he's considering, he doesn't really quite know what he's doing. Which is always nice to say before you lose to someone, of course. No rerolls for my opponent. And a really, really dense cage. Let's look at surfing options. That's nice. That's not bad at all. Yes, it does, stickers. Yeah, they do a bit. All right, see you, Barry. Thanks for the game. Good luck with yours. So Pro will allow you to reroll intercepts. It will allow you to reroll actions on. Okay, so this is a one die. Oh, but it's good. That is a pity. Stand up, block. Okay, this is an interesting move there. It's very chain pushable, this whole thing. Let's see. I can block here. I would need two guys there to make that work, though. Let's see. Starting off here. Good.
What is dead may never die.
What? Dead? 2, 3, 4. Ah, the witch is in the way herself. Right. So this block could push her after this one. I think that's better. Oh, really? Push here would suffice, yes, because now I can put him there. This gets her there, which means I didn't even need frenzy. In fact, it might be bad for the follow-up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 surf. So I think I'll take the pow here, because I really don't want to try and one die surf this guy when the ball is loose. But this is a nice surf though. Good. Where does the ball go? The ball goes badly for me. Which can stay here, that's okay. So unfortunately this ball is non-retrievable, which means I'm just gonna mark these two guys and hope he fails his reroll thing. But that was a solid surf. I could have made two goes to get on the ball, but probably would have used my last reroll. He doesn't have one. So that's 2, 2, 2, 2 for a touchdown. Good for you, Hunter. KO stays out. He's got an early score. I've got plenty of time for my own touchdown now. You could, but you would have a pretty small group of trials with alcohol involved at all, and quite a bunch with none whatsoever. This reminds me of the Balmer Peak. And if you don't know what that is, then you can look at the XKCD that I'm linking backwards in time right now. Okay, so surfing this blitzer, hopefully. Which might mean getting counter surf, but well, that happens. Since I don't need my blitzers to blitz with because of the surf, I can use them to block with instead, which means I'll have a Lino for carrying duty. He still has his witch, so that is something to take into account. I don't need this guy here, I'd rather have him there. I'll need at least one for going here, and one for going there, and then of course my own witch for the surf. Right. Yes. This will do for now. One, two, three, four, five, six, or one of these guys goes and get it. gets it. Say this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 would be there. Yes, but I do want to be here before I do that. I think I'll follow that. So I think somewhere between 7:30-ish, 7-ish p.m. GMT and 11-ish. Do I want to pick up before the surf? Kind of do. 3, 4, 5, 6. This is now safe. Yes. Come on, do it. Yes, excellent. No, I do that too, Stickers. Yes. In fact, I sometimes do so while playing, and I'm then confused that it doesn't work because I'm clicking my own bloody thing. Right, so the 145 league is usually matches are either structured or made through IRC, actually, Squiggy. Nice. Very, very nice. Excellent. So just general ranked games or black box are definitely a lot easier to arrange than some open league stuff. So this witch cannot surf here, which means this is actually a fairly safe spot, also protecting this guy. As soon as my connection restores, waiting for server, yes. So my connection sometimes drops for a second or so, and then Cyanide takes almost a minute to restore the connection. Nice. So you're hoping they will screw up more often than Hunter. Right, so this is all safe. This block is high odds. Let's put a guy here. Since he can already make two blocks anyway, I want to make it harder for him. Yeah, so ranked and black box are the two main divisions, Squig. And that's where I would advise you to go. Now, black box is random matchmaking, and there's... at high team value, it's very, very killer-oriented. If you play 10-15 games there, that's fine. You can find quite a bunch of variety. Who's the wrong person now? Ah, I see. Hunter. This is going into a half die here. Or, no, yes, a half die. Oh, wow. He makes the half die. That's rich. Well, so a lot of people will get that impression. There's a couple of bad apples there, but they also have their charm. it's really more the... So when people ask for skill advice and people on Fumble see that you have zero games played, their first response will be, well, go play on Fumble, rather than, oh, that's an interesting question, or sure, we can help. So while this is surfable, it's not probably not worth the number of risky blocks involved. Oh, and another good one. No! No! And we lost the witch.
God f***ing damn it!
So that's not good. Still got a couple of decent blocks here, so this is... I might just blitz this one, actually. Yeah, let's do that. Now I want to hurt his witch too, of course, but no! Let's see here, I would have two assists. Yeah, that's good. I want another two die on this witch elf. Yay! Got it. I'm not fouling her. So I've never played in Black Box much at all. I've played just about exclusively in ranked. So then this will be a 2-die, and then that will be a 2-die. The ball is not safe though right now, and this does not have blocks, so that's certainly a risk. Oh, but it's good right now. So what's nice about the 145 club... Oh, apparently I got a reroll. That's nice. One thing that's great about the 145 club is that they do also have spots for experienced coaches, but they have to play stunty races. So goblins, ogres, or halflings. Which means that you can play against decent coaches who can give you good advice. But they don't actually have incredible odds of winning against you. I think this is a nice spot. Closes off these guys a bit. I'm gonna make this one die. Yep, that's good. Yeah, so the one downside of starting off with a witch elf is, of course, exactly this phenomenon. Armor 7, no block, risk, no apo. Well, I mean, the witch is obviously fired. I'm not going to concede this. If I remake, I'm still just going to play my games. I haven't had a single concession on Cyanide, and I'm not going to start now. Okay, I didn't know that, Eldin. Nice. Yeah, block or wrestle is definitely the first skill to pick. So, I think Underworld can make a very, very cruel team value 1200 team or something, or 1300. At that team value, your opponents will still not have tackle, or at least not a lot of tackle. So you get a lot of value out of all of those goblins, and you can have three claw pomers with all normal rolls, and that is incredibly, incredibly nasty. So Underworld can make a really, really mean, lowish team value, or actually, yeah, low team value kill team. So I've still got 4 turns for this, which is plenty. I'm getting 3 blocks here. Okay, maybe not. Thanks for the follow, Gaga Boy. So, Vampires as a competitive team. Well, they've won a majors now, so that's something. I can blitz this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I would wind up there. With a passing play, I could get safe. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That might actually be worth considering at this point. Passing to this lineman and putting him there. That would make me safe for a turn and let me really focus on getting everyone out. I wouldn't say Underworld or Lizards are a stunty team. To me, only the 3 very low tier guys are stunty teams. The other teams just also have a stunty. It's like calling... No, this is normal weather. It's like sun and clouds. 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, so that's okay. And he's gonna go there, so I really want to screen here. I think here will do. I want to be here to lower the mobility on the witch. If I fail this... Well, the thing about the other stunty races is that they don't have any general access. That's really quite a large part of what makes them suck so badly. Right, so no one can reach that, right? The witch could, in theory. That just means I need someone here, basically. She can't surf, but she could blitz this. But if this guy is there, then that's suddenly a lot less attractive. This is kind of sloppy, though. This could have been a much nicer screen there. I'm going to assume this guy makes it out. Which means I'm going to have to reroll if he doesn't. But he does. Oh, so that was even sloppier. He should have been there, because now I made an unnecessary go for it. And, of course, tick-tock, tick-tock. Oh, nope, time. Well, at least I've got my screen up. I've got the ball safe. So the tiers, they do hold up, although they're based on... You can make them differently based on different things, right? If you're... Thank you, Seed. Yes. Oh, yeah. Let me fix that. So the tiers are traditionally based on the tabletop performance. And the tabletop performance is, of course, indicative of low team value gameplay. Right. I think I'd like it here. You can go there. So his witch is still on the floor, all of his guys are still over here. That makes my stall a hell of a lot easier. So I'm securing the ball first and then doing all the riskier stuff. This can help with this block. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I can blitz this guy with block over here, I suppose. Can she surf this? She can. That's a bit annoying. I guess he'll go here then. Oh, should have moved him afterwards, because if this is a failure, I don't want to be there. But it's not. So this is fine. Yes, sorry, Black Seed, I do this all the time. I noticed it when looking back on YouTube. Oh, it is. No, it's not a gun. So if I do lose track of what I'm saying, please remind me, because I've found it to be an incredibly annoying quality when looking back at my YouTube. But tiers. So the problem is that in order to properly define tiers, you need to include team value brackets. Because at team value 1000, chaos suck monkey balls. Whereas at team value 2500, chaos and Nurgle are the two best teams. Although elves can do pretty well up there as well. And Skaven-ish. So by trying to make tiers without taking team value into account, you're creating a team with very obvious flaws. So the only way to take tiering seriously is by including team value. I mean, some teams always suck, right? The halflings, the goblins, the ogres, they always suck by design. But teams like Amazons, for instance, are absolutely amazing at rookie team value, or at team value 1100, but they will suck at team value 2000 or something like that, because there will be a bunch of tackle. And we have another disconnect thingy going on. And we're back. So some teams are great at all team values. Dark Elves are one of them. Skaven are one of them. Chaos Dwarves are one of them. In Blood Bowl 2, Bretonians are the worst team around. Bretonians are to Blood Bowl 2 what the Stunties are to real Blood Bowl, basically. Which is a pity. Okay. Good. So, no serfs right now. Still got one turn of stalling. Not here, obviously, because this is no longer safe, but I've got five guys, so I can easily put it out there instead. Which means blitzing him. This guy. So the skill access on the blitzers are definitely the worst part of them. So the problem is not just that they have wrestle. Wrestle is a nice skill. The problem is that they have wrestle on players that have skill access that doesn't synergize at all with wrestle. So I could throw a block there. Yeah, that looks good. Yep. Good luck, Wolf. So this is two dice, and then this guy might be able to dodge out depending on stuff. That's good. And then we can go here. That's a go. Well, it's not a bad go to make, to be honest. One die here. Sure. the expensive rerolls are definitely a problem. That's why on my breaths, I only have two blitzers, because you really don't want to have a passing access guy as your main player. And they have only two rerolls. And as soon as one of the blitzers rolls a normals, he'll get leader, and I'll drop a reroll. So, 2 plus 4 plus half die. I'm not sure whether that's entirely the case, Stick has. I mean, Games Workshop has been showing renewed interest in Blood Bowl. I'm not sure they'll want to let Cyanide decide on the rules. If they do, I hope Cyanide asks for some good advice. The 4 plus is good, and the half die is, oh, also good. I still have a reroll and the ball, so it's not terrible. He does have enough players to get in my face. Yeah, that's true, Elden. Yeah, so I think if you want, you could be sort of competitive with Bretts at a very low team value, and that's about it. So I could probably chain push Villainich into a touchdown here. Let's see what this guy does now. Nothing. Okay. So that means assist here, blitz from there, chain push into him. Yes. Push will do, and you go here, and you have a touchdown. One-one. Halftime. So I would like to see how far I can push Bretts by staying at low team value. I mean, they foul well, they can do some damage. Yes, Squiggy, some sage advice would be highly recommended indeed. Yeah, it seems so, Seed. It seems so. Although the one die block on the witch was also pretty splendid. That was a 5 plus and it got a casualty. And on that note, here we go. No more witch means no more turn one serfs. Oh, man's LOS. I do still outnumber him by exactly one player. I've got 3 block. That sounds interesting, Squiggy. So who's Smoke DG60? I don't think I've even ever heard of him. So I mean, I've talked to Dode a fair bit on various forums and recently also on Steam chat a bit. He's a fun guy. He can get a bit upset at forum trolls, I suppose, but other than that, he's a cool guy. So, I'm exposing my players in order to get a lot of punches in. This is, of course, potentially disastrous, but I do think it's the right way to punish a setup like this. I have 2 rerolls, I've got 3 block, so I can make these 3 blocks first. One of the best level 1 coaches. Okay, I see. Thanks for the follow, Eridin. Oh, booger. Well, at least he doesn't have a lot of players and the kick is deep. This could be far worse. Well, if someone specializes in goblins, then they have to be a good guy, right? I've actually once pitch-cleared Nurgle with goblins. That was fun. That was a lot of fun. Okay. Well, as Blitz is against Elves Go, I've had worse.
Just do it!
Come on. Wow, that's got to be pretty damn rare. So, to make this 2 dice, I need 1 assist, that's going to be him. And then I can block, block, block. And after that, we'll see. Good. Here we'll do. Don't follow. Next. Good. Here we'll do. Don't follow. Next. Pity. There we'll do. Don't follow. So now I should be a bit more deliberate about things. 2 die, 2 die. This would be a 1 die. How far can he get? Not there. I think I'll pull this guy back for now. Probably here-ish. Or there to cancel this. No, here is good. Basically to limit his movement towards this side. That's needed, I would say. Blocks before the pickup still. That's 1. That's 2. Yes, very good. Here I think I will follow. Nice. Got myself a KO. Because these guys can dodge out, and that way I don't leave him with a lot of free blocks. Just this one, and he'll need some friends for that. I do think this is the right time to go for a pickup. I'm not going to move out with him, because she can threaten quite a bit down here, and he can threaten quite a bit down here. I'm willing to move one square. Yeah, so here. He can mark me if he really, really tries, but he cannot hurt me there. This guy out. Yes, excellent. Here will do. And this guy. There, I suppose. Yeah. Fine. Good turn. Good turn. Yeah, Gobbos can deliver quite a punch, although armor 9 is pretty tough for them to bash. Then again, so is Blodge. One thing that goblins can really hurt is Norse, for instance, because the chainsaw goes right through them, and at least a pow push will still kill them. And of course, armor 7. Yep. Skaven also. It's not like you win well against them, but you can really lay on the pain. As soon as opponents have all Blodge or armor 9, that becomes a lot tougher. Oh, you're right, Njord. I forgot, I think. Thank you. Yeah, absolutely right. No, that's not about greed, that's just sensible play to make a blitz there. Somehow I just didn't think about it because I was doing all of these blocks there. Yeah, my bad. My bad. And the connection thingy. It's weird because I went looking for a fix. I ran this script that's supposed to fix all your socket stuff. That's not true, Seed. I got one KO in there. This blitzer was on the pitch when he set up. Yes, thank you, Squiggy. So I outnumber my opponent quite considerably, although he did murder my witch. Hey, that's nice. He's got position on this side, but not on that side. This guy is blitzable, so I want to... Yeah, so my stream itself... So my streaming software only delays by a couple of seconds. I think this is a good spot. I'm just gonna go here. My OBS, the software that I'm using, only delays by a couple of seconds. And everything else is... 25? Really? Wow. Well, that's gotta be on Twitch's side of things, I think. So I want to pressure this guy and... see if I can surf him next turn. Securing this angle a bit is definitely worthwhile. Nice. Here's good. So he can either leave him there and not get to use him, which puts me at a player advantage. Or... So I could assist this block, but I think I'd rather assist this one. Yes, that is just good. I think 20 seconds is still a hell of a lot, to be honest. Right, so that's bad. And then we get a one die. Stay here because then I can mark this guy and not get blocked by that one. And that's all because these are very much needed where they are right now. Still giving him a 4 plus half die again. But statistically, that shouldn't work as often as it does for him. I really wouldn't know, Elden. I barely watch streams at all. Sometimes when I'm a bit too tired to stream myself or just finished, I'll hang around in someone else's stream for a little bit. So when I've actually been playing quite a bit of Mordheim while off stream. A large part of that, the reason for that is that Mordheim doesn't lend itself well to windowed play, and I like seeing the chat in the stream. So I've been playing a bit of Mordheim off stream, and it's actually quite a lot of fun. I suppose it might, Monkey G. I don't know how they organize, how Twitch organizes its servers. But it might do, yes. Well, I also need a new first monitor because my current one is really bugging out terribly. Basically what it does is if it goes into sleep mode or shut down and I if I shut down my monitor, I will basically it will not turn on again 90% of the time, so it means I actually have to unplug it and replug it in and keep doing that for a bunch of times until it somehow magically does work again. And this happens a couple of times a day, basically. Right, so wait, that's his blitzer. Block there, blitz there, proceed this end. Yeah, I think that's good. Nice, build to win. Oh wait, I need an assist here first. Which is... okay. So I'm gonna have to take some slight risks at some point. Unavoidable. Good. So now I can go here, I suppose. That's not bad. And then blitz with this guy. I will need one go, but I will reroll it if it fails. Getting a guy on here is certainly also a good idea. Then I can make this block afterwards. Oh, that's two goes, is it? Will I still want to make it if the first one fails? Yes, I do. But here we go. Yay, made it. Not good enough, but made it all the same. I think I'd rather blitz this, block this one actually. So I'm gonna go like this instead. Yay, got him. He's gonna go there, and I'm not following. That way, he has to work to get a block there.
Fatality.
What is dead may never die.
Right. So that went well. One die here. I think dodging out is better at this point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, and he's gone. Ooh. Good winnings. Nice. That's a 10k short of a new witch. But Blitzer MVP is good. So I suppose at this point I might as well get a fourth Blitzer.